Buene Benifas. Poetic Prose, Poem Anderson. B.Y. Walker of Love. Sergio Sanz Navarro. Publicado con la editorial Libros con Atenea. Visita nuestra web www.librosconatenea.es y descubre la cultura del siglo XXI. Dissatisfaction. Oh, to write to you, so many nights and so many days with you, strange sensation of my impressionless days, ghostly siren song, close as the darkness of an abyss without a glimmer of light. From where do you get so much desire? From where do you get so much longing and so much restlessness? What is it that you want, truly, that my sweet love is not enough for you? You take me through the streets aimlessly, through time without a clock, wandering without respite, campus without a course and simply on God's ears. You exhaust me when I listen to you, you make me desperate when I believe you, you enlighten me when I embrace you. Languid low, fabricator of stories, fuel searches in the forests and on the beaches of the unknowable. You come to me and you alarm me. You only calm down occasionally when everything comes together for you and fate and death art cease to exist. Groan of relaxation, relativity in the absolute, bitter nameless and blissless tear that burns me inside, which water will quench your thirst, which woman, which unbridled night of pleasure will soothe your cravings. No. You are no longer my master and yet sometimes, so many times, more than you would like. I am your slave and with your lease you lead me along the paths of experiences that, if they had a name, we could call them ruin, failure and frustration, and had you not taken me to total ecstasy at our times, I wouldn't even listen to you anymore. Do you have entrails, perchance? Through where do you sip the nectar that you demand? You bleed me dry when, blind to your impulses, I fall and forget myself and those I love. You, who lead me to a solitude that I know and kindly give affection to, when will you live my life, purple beacon of the drifting of my existence? There is no virtue to aid you it seems, no look or cares to fulfill you, you always want more and more like a dog barking into the void. Writing about you gives me some satisfaction and the thing it does you too, as if by doing so I can listen and grow to comprehend the unknown language you speak amidst shadows, noise and boredom. Only in the silence of my heart do you sometimes raise your weary ethereal body above me and tell me so many things that you want, that you don't want and there is so much incomprehension for not knowing what you want that only I can, in the integrity that I can gather from myself, offer you the serenity of this resting walker. I am here for you. I can only tell you that I love you Sergio, whoever you are, whatever you do, whatever you think or whatever you feel, I am here for you. To hold you in the depths of darkness where the future seems not to exist and the fears and worries lurk. I can't do anything else for you, I know that you are eaten up by insecurity and meaninglessness, that sometimes you feel powerless but here I am. I can't guarantee that you won't make any more of what you call mistakes, but you can try to be as aware as possible. All my love is here, I am here for you. Prayer of surrender. Life, love, divinity. I surrender everything to you. I surrender you my emotions, my thoughts, my desires, my teeth, my molars, my body, my desires, my expressions, my happiness, the money you want to earn, my worries, my needs, I don't know what to do with it all. I surrender to you all my relationships, my yearnings, my worries, my personal missions, my weariness, my guilt and shame. I surrender to you my journeys, my arms, my legs, my conflicts, everything. I surrender to you my past, I surrender this moment to you, I surrender to you my future. I surrender to you my fear to express myself, I surrender to you the stigmas I carry, all my ideas, everything I adore, everything I believe in, I surrender it to you. I surrender myself to you. When fear traps you in it is loneliness and helplessness. Makes you shake. Breathe, and if you want to, say to fear, come here, to the warmth of the love that flows from this heart. Breathe, and if you want, say to sadness, come here, so that it can shed its leaves and germinate a flower of compassion. May the trembling be able to be softened by the calm that mercy pours out and the mystery of pain be dissolved in the clear water of forgiveness. And may your life harmonize in the song of this day of an evening and may the night become a purple cloak of oxygen where the arcane plants metabolize the noise of unrest and fill your innocent body with peace. May the weapons rust and there be no more cries but those of orgasms and groans of pleasure and cheers of celebration, and my existence rock you with its breath of silence and its symphonic lullaby. My tensions melt away and there be no more death and no more cries of woe, my we humans comprehend each other in the serene bed of inevitability, and my your face searing and your brown heart be furrowed in disdain and exhaustion. My tears be your rest and renew you from within and my pens not fail to offer the ring to poetry. May the light blue and white of the sky be the homeland where your ecstasy expands. May you awaken from the dark sleep of guilt and the incomprehensible magic of oneness restore your smile for you to feel safe in eternity. About life as an aesthetic experience. Some of my writings do not try to teach anything, they do not develop or dissect a subject, they are not useful, they only arise from an experience that I feel, that is invoked in me and wants to share and expand itself. They are like those films in which you don't even try to make an effort to understand the script and you use enjoy the journey. When you look at life with a loving disposition and a desire to see beauty, you find yourself immersed more and more each time in an incomprehensible experience where art shimmers in what you contemplate and you are flooded by a full and serene smile that inhabits everything. You could find yourself in what could be just decadent situations, sordid environments, with rough people or even submerged in pain. But if the perfume of a compassion that strips the dark mist of all obtuska and damnation rises in the flight of your gaze you will be able to see tender beauty, mystic art and that light. That indescribable light that serenades without you knowing why like a chalice of anxiolytic passion, that light that seeps through gaps and cracks that do not exist and from which you drink everywhere, that goes through you and hydrates you like soft and sweet my water. Here is here one of those writings with you. Of what form is experiential poetic prose. Life is an uncontrollable to and forth, a dance with mystery, a divine dance, an iratasism that appears and disappears as glimmers of grace like the path like floating lanterns in the black night. Bits of trust pulsing in the heart of the unintelligible, visual songs at dusk in the wide verse of space distilling infinity with its sound of eternal silence. About that flows and glides through lyrical landscapes of uncontainable and wild beauty, of real, liquid and etheric surrealism. A cryptic language that is comprehended while listening without being retained and renounces any decoding. Love smiling through all things as perfection beholds everything with its eyes of gratitude and becomes full. On the delightful seas of the irrational, an experience of devotion. An open heart that embraces the whole universe creates a life experience of love that cannot be conceptualized and that harmonizes and softens your life. A oxygen of ecstasy, poppy flower, sweet essence of panela sugar water with lemon. Jasmine and orange blossom poppy alate the winds of this abode, existence. Sublime gait, slow and steady walk, graceful movement, confident fluidity. Gypsy women who sing with their mischievous gaze and charming melody of all of that seems elusive, playful, but which inevitably spills over the corners of the black contours of their eyes. Sidaxian of celebration in the evening meadows of the neighborhood silly fin. Iraitas roses right when they breathe, they exhale their scent of gratitude without protocols, their selfless song, their om, their vibration. They sound like the guitar sound on the beaches of my feelings. They dance like the women dance on the Mexican porches of my memory. They glorify how poetry appears from musicians who sing in the metro carriages. And they discover me. They find me perplexed, drunk with joy, exultant with wonder, immersed in myself, immersed in you, immersed in everything. Placid from placidity. Fresh, like Madrid in the spring, so is my heart, fresh, like the spring water of the divine desire that we are, like the love that flows when I share myself. Moonlight and night do we breathe. The windows open and the echoes of the music of the houses around me enter and I drink in the smell of their aromas through my ears. And the trees opening all their pores, emitting their celebration, their enchanted mermaid song in which I melt and let myself breathe, and my mouth tastes sweet when the saliva that my organism expresses metabolized sweetness of the peach of life rises from inside. and my voice vibrating caressing my throat from within while still inside between whispers the verses that alight from my heart and go through it like ships invoked by an orange setting sun. And my smile becomes eternal, why does the sky and my heart rejoices and I fall in love with myself, loving and delighting in the ecstasy of the incantation of creation and words run through me like an internal shower that bathes this landscape with calm, reverberating in brilliance, in extensive echoes of absolute beauty. Then forgiveness hatches from within, peeling away illusions from anywhere is and you can't template the open path of existence, the infinite gift that vibrates behind all perception or interpretation and noises dissolving to the sonora silence of the full song of the universe. Present prophecy of love. And you will contemplate this elation without being afraid, I will feel it all with love, letting myself be loved in my defenselessness. I will forgive myself for having created this experience of separation and one day I will laugh, I will smile without any doubt in the certainty of what I am. I don't know what I am doing here, to love, I don't know where I am, I am swimming in God, life with its absurd and that the same time harmonic, indefinably perfect ups and downs. I forgive myself for having broken my feet looking for love, I had all drunkenly in the corner of the carriage to write these verses and I embrace myself. And while it asserts the cry of failure and ruin in my mind I will be undisturbed and cross all boundaries of dignity until I no longer even know what it is, until only my being here is a fierce look of love and absence of attack. And I will dissolve in the absence of control, I will breathe while fear shakes my bones and I will delight in feeling my absolute innocence in the inevitable. And as the rain falls over Madrid and the grey calm floods the entire metro as I travel, I will let myself be caressed by this inexplicable tranquility. And whole lakes of poetry will flood me with every tear and fall to the ground like a rain of prayer and all my dust will come loose and the veils that seemed to cover love will fall and everything will become a perfume of an intoxicating spring of passion. And the swallows will fly at the sight of the bard singing and the exegetes will take to the streets proclaiming their astonishment, their perplexed confusion and torbadors will compose verses that like the muezzin have the notes of a song without a name and they will continue to weep from feeling how writing regenerates me and the money will never again be a worry. And they will feel again all the love in my heart of all those who loved me and rejection will no longer be an option. And love will continue to secret itself in me and there will be no more truth for there will be no more absence of peace. And the strange days will no longer be a dark enigma, they will undoubtedly be a blessing, they will no longer be the fading nostalgia of a lost paradise and they will be flower water of eternal bliss. Glimmers of light. True observation is non-evaluative, non-conclusive and non-judgmental. True observation is imbued with love and caresses and rests its gentle attention on and among what it observes, mechanisms, thoughts, situations, without wanting to eliminate it or do anything with it, freeing it from any weight of guilt and wrongness, even of evaluation itself. This gaze will transform your life by flooding it with love and sweet joy and peace. It is an infinite space, true observation ceases to see all conflict, becomes blind to it and sees only the real, the serene and infinite ocean that you are and where you eternally share love and fullness until time and demandingness are diluted. Impurity is a belief. A state of suspicion about oneself, of suspicion about the purity of my intention. The observation of whether the intention came from the ego, a character or the self was a waystation to discern and secure the recognition of my being but it can become an interference, a hindrance to spontaneity. When the dichotomous mind is diluted, the ego and the characters are seen as love and cease to be something separate from it, then we live without thinking and flow from trusting what emerges and flows through me without abstracting, strangling or minimizing it. I am. Impurity is not real, it is a perceptual distortion of the unquestionable purity of the divine expressing itself through you. Alchemy of mercy in the back and forth of wandering. And in the terror of loneliness I search for a sense of companionship and sometimes I find only a murmur. A cheap and aimless anaesthesia. Only when I breathe you, in me, my heart is serene and relaxed. I only find sense in writing, I collect myself there while the world bowls, while I strut myself watching the girls pass by and I dream my salvation in them ephemerally, my peace, my oasis. Only here in these writings do I find the alchemy that consoles me, only here occurs photosynthesis in a oxygen of love from the disordered carbon dioxide of perceptions that reign over me. and alcohol is already a strong water that soothes this mild despair, sometimes she would like to disappear and then inexplicably in the distance see the light of a sunset dawning and the fall in love with life again. These are the days when he wouldn't stop writing. Police sirens search the streets for crime and no longer manage to distract me from the committed vigil of innocence I came here to express and live. I open wide my eyes and my heart like a mad devotee of a Parnassus of delirium of intasis and I cry when I recognize myself, when I feel my beauty in the middle of devastation, guilt pursues me and I have become so agile at avoiding it, like the one who ignores Satan's tricks. And reggaeton plays in the distance, inviting me to dance, to lose myself in the party, but I can only breathe and expand in these islands. I don't even bother to ask why I force him to leave, I don't even flinch at the temptation of regret. Everything has become a soft hardness in me, like the protagonist of a love western. It's so much beauty at times, as if I can't take it all in, and at other times the terror dreams like the thundering of a saucepan. What a strange world this is, what a tender stage for love, the playground of the fearless child of God who abandons himself secure in his invulnerability. And here I am in the corner of a park, on a bench, with a recently bought notebook and surrounded by bars, people and echoes of enjoyment, relating it all from the balcony of my self-merciful eyes. And the rain continues to fall, carefree, and I fear the moment to stop writing like someone who fears that the effect of the drug that made them not feel the abstinence of God will wear off. And yet there is no greater illusion than abandonment, there is no orphanhood in the heart of the universe. Loneliness is only a mad and abstain itself exclusion from the purity of what is happening. And I can do nothing other but honor you brother, sister, you and each one of the sometimes weary walkers and adventurers of existence. I surrender myself to the fate of the poet, the writer or whatever this is called, I surrender myself to infinite love. Sinning eyes. Medium of mad love, stenographer of the symphony of the unraveling of the inadmissible, in the cold I dwell but I am not cold, in beauty I bathe, in carry you without a position I dance, in soft carry you, frictionless, that embraces friction, in carry you that is not carry you, it is life. Because carry is not bravado, it is infinite and than a shame dignity, shameless, carry is being undaunted by the wailing echoes of the illusion of helplessness because helplessness is a decision you make in the instant you believe in guilt. Desire, as yield as it is the injury as is the torrent of love making its way to the place in you where you believe you can decide and that the same time you decide. And so my dream of being constantly gone love is awakening, yes, to be located in the real, to be that crazy and misplaced, for it is love that is actually misplaced now. I became an accomplice of the unusual, art of art and this sensuality everywhere. Smiling in me. He closed his eyes and listened to her singing and they could really connect with and melt with her in his heart, her voice was like a sweet tide that dissolved all loneliness. And suddenly he was moved by the way so much beauty was segregated from all supposed incomprehension and life became living, pulsating art. Then there was nothing more to comprehend, used to be fierce in this radical love. And all plans about going to Egypt, of MDMA orgies and romantic dates, could fall apart, because he had gone mad with love, he had found meaning, my non-mechanical function, peace that informed me of perfection and besides he had money for beer and for photo copying poems and handing them out. And there was new music, everywhere. The excitement of the expectation of the unforeseeable. Then you begin to realize that you are falling in love with things not turning out as you expected, as you wanted or thought you wanted, they don't know has become so profound that the expectation of surprise has replaced tense and demanding expectation. And you are even happy when everything is goes wrong, you smile like someone who knows that his or her lover has, a surprise party in store for him or her. Walking down the street. It was when you looked at me not believing that you had seen me that you finally saw me and I saw you. It was when the dense mists cleared that our infinities crossed in a single point of love's expansion. An ocean of calm. There is an oceanic calm in the depths of me, in the deepest part of you, a tangible silence like that of the morning that soaks and floods everything where all worries can lie down to rest and dissolve. It is like dropping into the very depths of uncertainty where we find the divine mystery of what we really are. It is a certainty without words that is experienced and needs no assurances, Ayental fermnis me ido fanimens querida tu hibridu era urbrezo aidans and de hart inexplicabli rilloisis andre cagnaisas dat certanti. Itis der werol fears become serene and guilty silence as if they were confused and disordered cries that find their symphonic and ansiolytic nerisimant in the souls of our deepest being, then timelos esoluate, the past becomes an echo of gratitude and the future becomes a blissful present unfolded in the now where you enjoy the embrace you give yourself and give to everything. And all sadness is unveiled as compressed love that, when released, restores the sparkle to our eyes of a hope that realizes and consumes itself in the flourishing of a fullness that demands nothing and receives everything with kindness. And the more loving you are to yourself, the more courageous you are to surrender yourself to the journey of the expansion of infinite love. We are all together. I love you. 70 times 7. Sergio was a very strong trip, sometimes it seemed like it would never end. But it was always the same destination. Hugging oneself again and again. Squeezing you together sleeplessly. A querida and irrepressible impulse in his veins, a spell of unbridled and dandante impassion. I was in love with absurdity and disaster and loved to share the etymology of this word. A beautiful explosion of the stars. Rock bottom was no longer, because the guy really loved himself, he loved himself free of prototypes or typologies, it was a kind of unconditional permission that led him to debauchery more than once. It was no longer a matter of responsibility, God experienced enjoyment through me, it was his unsacrificed heart. And everything had turned into a crazy love fest full of sparkling eyes that bold and let me rest and that the same time filled me with the most delicious piece of the universe. Malva. Frustration arrived with its pyrotechnic dance and disdain for all expectations had turned into a fierce look of horror of love towards any self-remorse. Nothing in the city revolved around the whimsical sense that some partial and real self had invented. Everything was a wild provocation to my unconditionality, to my capacity to sustain myself in the disbelief that is only devoted to what is not credible, to the unmiracled miracle. The humidity of the DRY room. Sometimes I feel so lonely that I feel like an orphan in a cold universe and I can do nothing but let love into me again and again. Sometimes life becomes a delirium of insomnia. And my body trembles and all embraces remain outside me in an unbearable hollowness that I can only feel by breathing calmly. Sometimes I feel so tired that I can't even rest. Sometimes loneliness turns everyone into strangers and at the same time I feel damp close in the heart of a compassion that becomes enough for me to taste the sweetness of life again. Sometimes I can only beg for eternal forgiveness for my whole life. And free myself. Conversations with Carlin. Question from a friend. What is your perception of attachment? Answer. That it is totally forgivable. And that we have to be very kind to ourselves when it manifests itself. And allow it internally. Even if we are afraid to love because we confuse love with attachment. Everything is intertwined. It is a great opportunity to free oneself of fears. Attachment is fear. In my case I am also afraid of attachment arising in my partner, but despite that I am still open. In my previous relationships, attachment has been very present. I have only been able to free myself from it by allowing it and being totally loving towards myself. By putting aside any forced attempts at behavioral change. Allowing it how? Allowing it internally. It's like not attacking it, not choking it, not interrogating it, not punishing it, not intimidating it. Completely the opposite of what we usually do. Inner permission frees us from everything. Completely the opposite of what we used to believe, that permission makes things persist. A teacher was once asked, when is jealousy healed? And they said, when you stop having a problem with it. And there is no end to permission. It grows wider and expands. And it becomes pure joy. An enjoyment that transcends all attacks. Question from a friend. And this is where the question arises, how does one do that? How does one love everything? How does one see love in everything? Response. The how is a decision. It is allowing love to do it for you, it is acknowledging that you don't know how. Love does not force you to know. It is like that. My attitude in every moment is as if I am open and all the time there is an implicit question in me that is totally open and says, what would it be like to love this moment? love, do it through me, y open myself. It is letting go of the arrogance that I know what is happening or what is going to happen, start saying I don't know. The more you say I don't know, the more you allow love to come in. It is to start ignoring all those thoughts that lead you to bitterness, to conflict, and to attend to the feeling with love, embracing it. It's those two things, that way you maintain yourself in an open disposition for love to come through you. It is a decision, moment by moment that way dance, you start to fall in love with that decision, you start to realize that all you want is to decide that over and over again and that every scenario is perfect for you to see where it is necessary for you to bring love and expand it and share it, and all those vibrations dissolve into the love that you are. And that in the moment that you are having that experience, you are sharing it with the whole universe. It is tremendously big, every time you decide to embrace yourself, it is tremendous what is happening in the universe, it is incredible. And it is simply that. It is to leave ourselves in the hands of love. Every time we punish ourselves, it is as if we were saying you know what to do. You are starting to allow it, it is already starting to happen in you. What is happening is that you have anxieties like you have had and often when you have them you need to look for a how to that produces more effective or quicker results, but the embrace itself is more important than the experiential effect of the embrace. Believe me that, step by step, it will open and there will be moments in your life where this feeling lives, when you can't stand to suppress yourself anymore, because the softer you are the more that everything that is asking for love inside of you will be released. It is a gentle path. You never take a step without love, you are accompanied at all times. Love is always here, your path is perfect, open yourself to it, don't impose it on yourself mentally, you allow the feeling of inability, all that you perceive as inability, allow it, y allow it, the key to connect with the capacity to love everything is to allow your inability, to embrace it to the nth degree. A joy that comes from the recognition of the greatness of who you are. Because by allowing, you discover your infinite capacity to love. We can only accept what is if we first accept what is. That is why love is to be accepted first, followed by fear. It is letting yourself be loved in the midst of fear. First you accept the gift and then the acceptance of everything that puts us in a state of conflict arrives as a natural consequence. We tend to think that we have a bigger shadow than others, but these are use meaningless comparisons that distract us. Don't take any notice, the shadow is not a bad thing, it's just the parts of us where we have not yet allowed love to enter. It's simple, the only thing you have to allow yourself is to be loved at all times. It's your only function here. So is mine. Don't worry about anything else. By receiving it you share it with the whole universe and it expands through you. You receive love from within, in your centre, you open your heart inwards. The infinite source is there. You breathe love. Zawan Square. That square in the neighborhood was magical. If you felt desolate one day you used had to go down there was music everywhere and people open to chatting. You would go down there to write, to fall in love with so many people that it frustrated me that I couldn't meet and kiss them all. There were perfumes everywhere and a lot of cool girls who had an infinite gaze where you would lose myself like when you are bewitched by looking at the horizon of the sad sunset. And then all of a sudden life danced with me and the surprises came to me like yesterday when I met you and you gave me a taste of your sweet smoke, that moment in the middle of the park loving from the suburbs and underworlds of love, and the conversation with your daughter where for a moment I felt like a sweet father or a cool stepfather and tears came to my eyes. I fell in love with so much innocence, so much beauty. I felt totally accompanied and loneliness became use a mirage, the dark ejaculation of fear. I also sang love songs to my neighbor without her knowing it. I sang them connecting myself with her ex-husband because I heard them arguing on that day when I left home, they were both adorable and their little daughter was a blessing from heaven. There were such beautiful details in my life, things that I did that made me nearly know before myself. And sometimes he was the only one who witnessed them and he didn't need to say anything about it because he even forgot about it, because love is nothing special and that the same teammate always is. Sometimes it was embracing you being miserable and needy not believing the story of the miserable one and the needy one or even knowing what they are. Other times it was a back and forth, You should have taken advantage of the moment because you didn't know if you would ever talk to that girl again and that the same teammate didn't deprive me of being relaxed. That was the risk you was taking, to experience it as if I was going to see her again. Anyway, exposing myself was inevitable. My eyes were two unified portals that called for mischief and when they crossed yours, beauty flooded everything with the spell of the divine magic of infinite love. Choosing was impossible, I had already let go of that old dream, used to breathe and to love. Used to fly. From the casino park, from the bad of Morad to the pink lean of your desire and your freshness. I had a date with her but she didn't know she had a date with you. Queen of tattoos, of the slutty and pure gaze. Yesterday you ride around the bathroom like a goddess, filling everything with your sweet fluid. Yesterday you killed me and vivified me, you taught me what it is to go beyond and fall short and to go here more and to travel to infinity. Yesterday in the ambassador's neighborhood, I was ambassador of nothing but your ecstasy which was mine and was free. I filled all your sadness and sexiness with kisses and dignity, I sucked your whole body and your pussy was the soft source of my mouth. And the battles were falling and everything was ruined and we felt anxious and I was always present. I loved you, you loved me and it ended, who knows, and it still lasts in these islands and these caresses that harden my cock and make my heart dance. The crazy offering of my surrender. I stopped living in conflict with life. I was no longer listening to the condemnations of a collective and assumed guilt. The team had come to abandon the furious guidance of a lost voice. An ideal of evolution that was not an expansion of the vision of love in everything was over, and love knew no evolution. That was use another spiritual race more absurd than Formula One racing and of course you could enjoy or suffer along with it if you wanted to but it was getting more and more risible. I had become an irresponsible person. Yes, I had stopped taking charge of everything and I was flowing with everything I had to take care of and I felt more and more that life was only asking me to enjoy, and I was throwing myself towards it again and again violently orgasmically without violence towards it. So my team is love. Sometimes love sent me to shine in hell. And hell was sometimes a whorehouse, sometimes a drag den, the bank account or a square, and sometimes it was your eyes aflame with inexplicable and senseless judgment. Sometimes love killed me at night, I felt I was dying between energetic vomiting and sepulchral silences and sidereal sirenic songs of suicide. Sometimes love filled my feet with souls and urged me to keep walking. Once it sent me a plague of boredom that drove me crazy with love for the celebration of life and festivity. Sometimes love sent me to the police again and again, dressed in blue it came little, but I saw the truth in thousands of eyes that rejected me with their disgusting suspicion and when at night I woke up I didn't even see it in the mirror and the love that I am said to me and it came out, out loud. I love you. Spiritual bankruptcy. I had enough of your tests or your jokes or I don't know if I was putting them on myself. All my bones ached and my heart had less light than a siac, but I did my best to shine, and although my wrists ached, I did my best to write and wrote on paper as the King of Kings did on the ground with a stick. I loved my father and my mother so much and that night I listened to him and in the morning she prayed for her. And I dreamt of a woman who would save me, but where was she, my God, where was she? And in the morning she would tremble and I would wake up in tears. Sometimes I felt that the world was crazy and I was the craziest, there was so much humiliation and contempt and I transmuted it into glory. But there was always gratitude in my heart and when the sun came through the window my eyes lit up. And the silence screamed, I felt that I was lost, that I could not find myself among so many battles absent of the scent of flowers and without meaning. When I found myself 7,000 blessings I threw them to the four cardinal points of my homeland the world and the sky descended and I cried out for mercy to a God to forgive me and who sometimes I felt was deaf. And I gave thanks again and again for freedom, for being able to breathe there outside of imprisonment and to see your eyes once more at the cold and beating gates of my delirium. Better in bad company. Tan alone you said to S.A.Y. When you are submerged in a solitude imposed by circumstances and boredom devours you like a blinding black mist, you are capable of begging for love even from hordes of mowing Vikings who plunder your life and your house to the point of ruin by sucking your blood. You also beg from the bulldogs full of duplicity who only seek to abuse and humiliate you, it happened to me and I take responsibility for putting it on a platter. However, When you find tenderness in someone eyes, you enjoy every second until the illy ran away. When it was a woman, he didn't even need a kiss or a vigor eyes he hug anymore, even if he longed for it. You simply enjoy her sweet presence, sit beside her and offer a gentle coolness of peace and embrace, a good shade in which she can take a break, rest, breathe out, and burden herself and sin and dance together to the sound of the air of life. When your mobile phone is stolen and you have no way of communicating with those you love and desire most, there are two options. If you have the strength, you take to the streets for a fortuitous and synchronous meeting, or if you don't, you wait at home for the ringing of the doorbell, which then becomes a bell of joy. There are people who out of some strange rejection or unworthiness or mistrust or think you have some ulterior motive with them, as perhaps they themselves have, and are not able to receive all the love you have, so, what do you do with all that love? Where does it go? It's frustrating, maybe they get overwhelmed. I don't know. I have so much love to give, that sometimes I summon all the rivers into my eyes and cast them with the beam of a gaze that is lost in the infinite black of the pupils of theirs, where the gleam of their denied desire to be deeply loved and received as I am lies. And here I find myself fervent with fascination and awe at their beauty, which they even unintentionally give off until it is overshadowed by some strange stubbornness to turn away. Patience, gentleness and respect and they will come closer but not all will, it all lost many people he loved for strange rude and provocative reactions born of that refilling, that is, of all those magical feelings turned backwards that he could not see as he would have liked to and could only sing to the skies or to the ground. Can I sing a song for you? Sometimes that song that was born in my heart even though she said no to me, he jokingly sang it to her without permission because he felt her blushing. And sometimes when she gave me her permission, other jealous and envious thugs would hit me arguing that he was bothering them even though she said it wasn't so. Don't stop shining, brother, sister. Don't submit yourself to the unjust dictatorship of bitterness. It is true that sometimes he boasted with cockiness and arrogance because respect is towards the dignity of the other and false respect is to submit yourself in fear of their violence. Do not deprive yourself of yourself or of your enjoyment and do not deprive the world of the light you have come to share with it, with us. If you want to share it with me we will shine together. I love you. The internal cold. Sometimes I feel a coldness that distances me even from my own body and I don't even feel its warmth and companionship. Sometimes the blankets are not enough to warm the deepest marrow of my bones. Sometimes fear draws the darkest scenarios in my mind and its sensations cascade down like waterfalls into my heart, freezing it and leaving a trail of desperate desolation. I am thankful that I am not an orphan, that I have parents who love me and accompany me and who help me with their presence to get out of the trenches of the most stubborn and obstinate negativity. I am thankful to have friends who encourage me to trust and to love with, I am thankful for all the people who pray for me. I give thanks for not drinking the alcohol of doom and ruin. Sometimes I feel a relaxation that blows every mute scream of terror away like a gentle wind and then I can breathe in peace and sleep peacefully. Sometimes I use need to cry and be embraced and all the black thorns are expelled from my soul as if they were made from the ethereal fabric of the illusion of a nightmare, and then the future becomes clear again and the light of the hope of dreams born of the love that beats in me and that wants to be shared with the whole universe enters through its window, and I receive from everything and everyone even without asking for it which is the most glorious, pleasurable and full of blessings and then I ask that sometimes it be forever. And rest eternally breathing the humid aroma of a land without boredom and suffering filled with the infinite musical or silent forms of the dancing celebration of life that defeated death. Rilke S. Panther. There are times when I really don't know where to go, I don't feel comfortable anywhere and I can't sit still either. These are the times when you said to drink harder but now that I don't drink I feel like a panther in a cage. It's sad to feel that sometimes I feel that life is meaningless without alcohol running through my veins. News writing calms me down, because I am relieved that maybe when someone reads this they might not feel so alone if the same thing happens to them. In those moments I miss those places where the people are with who and from where I missed the places and the people I am with now. It is like a quicksilver, a restlessness, a search for a constant joyful intensity. An intolerance to a frustration that comes from the clash of my expectations with what is happening and that only melts away with partying or with surrender or with the sweet presence of female friends. I long for a surprise, a female face that recognizes me even if she don't know me. I am less and less clear about the next step to take, but nevertheless I am regaining more and more the strength to take it. I feel dependent on my every whim, I feel like a boy and a man at the same time and I often feel tired even though I do less and less things. Sometimes I feel immature, sometimes a victim, sometimes an idiot or incapable, but I listen less and less to the voice of guilt. And although there are many reasons to regret, something deep inside me tells me that no matter how painful, long or strange you had happened is, whatever happened was the only thing that could have happened and I wonder if that is how we refuse to learn or if life is an uncontrollable river that don't even give us the option to let ourselves go. Sometimes all this is a silence to any breath and rest and my lungs are once again filled with serenity and love, with the desire to live and enjoy. But there are other moments when nothing is a silence and everything is an empty and terrifying noise that even if you cover your ears you can't stop hearing. Everything bothers me when despair overwhelms me, when I am annihilated by the stupor of misfortune, when I feel that others are more fortunate than me and I wonder what it is that they see in me that they don't like and pushes them away. I hate it when you look at me and I feel desire in your eyes and when I come closer you turn away. What kind of perverse game is that? What a maddening ambivalence that I once participated in and that I didn't comprehend either. What kind of game of false power we humans are playing while love slips through the cracks of its sewers leaving us dry with the minimum, impoverishing the diabolical pride that only lives each one of us in the corner of our conditioning, most of which we don't even know about, each of us looking for what we want or what we think we want and most of the time with a lost look in our eyes unable to find each other as if there was an unbridgeable fissure between us humans that only death or radical love could fill. Regeneration. As the days went by and I rested in the gentle, red lands of my village, peace again came to the shores of my heart and crept in like a gentle divine comfort that filled me with an incomprehensible trust that informed me with its sweet voice that everything was as it should be, that all was well. The tears that flowed were no longer tears of sadness, and beyond some spontaneous outburst of sulky anger that I didn't know where it came from and was more like a hangover from a nightmare that had passed. Those tears that no longer fell were the fruit of a blessed alchemy of gratitude. I was surrounded by people who really loved me, by my childhood friends and the horizon of a new life in Guadalajara was opening up, full of tranquility and a joy that needed no exaltation, and that was festive revelry of bliss and reunion, a beautiful, a really beautiful new encounter. I was at home both inside and outside and everyone supported me. Calm had returned and I never wanted to stray again or visit the black, muddy swamps of despair. As the pastor one day prophesied to me, God had given me a second or rather another chance, and yet, it had all been a perfect apprenticeship guided by love and I was willing to go through the consequences of those months I had spent half blind, but I prayed that they would not be bitter condemnations but undertakings that would build me up and push me further and further away from the hole I had dug myself into. I knew with certainty that, at its path, prosperity was coming and I had my arms wide open to it. A sweat with a puff. We went into the darkness together to discover the light. We lost ourselves in the mournful night, to light the purple torches of consummate desires that in their insatiability were infinitely satiated. We killed each other in screams of fury, in blind wars, and we embraced again without slapping each other on the backs, but with soft and tender depth. We kill ourselves in mental prisons and aporias that never really existed. To discover what it is to fly suspended in the quite ungraspable perfection that opens up when we don't draw conclusions about what is happening. We danced strange dances with death as we sighed in fear that we would not fall into ruin and we lifted our bodies again, breathing at the top of our lungs as we sang the victory hymns of eternal redemption and celebration. We dreamt bucolic landscapes while laying on the pavement we languished in solitude and returned together to sing fresh raspberry tarts is a reggaeton and full-hearted flamenco. We dreamed, yes, and sometimes we lived the fantasy of furtive, impossible loves, that only show impassable when our glances crossed and we melted oceanically with the whole without anyone existing but that sweet sensation of freshness of encounter, of mojito, of passion's mischief. We fell, yes. We fell, incomprehensibly guided, we fell. We wanted to control and in the end we let go of what we never held and could never hold, we relaxed in the freedom of not having to decide, to choose. For we learned that there is only one choice, passable, real. Surrender. Altogether we went in and out to re-enter from where we never left, from the most precious open room there is. The room of love. From the balcony of my eyes. From the balcony of my dreams I look out on the purple and smoky horizons of my imagination. Lie down and drank with nostalgia for bitter if there had been sand oxygenating you could have, I look around, uneasy, in search of the sensations and experiences that will satiate my thirst with bliss. Loneliness sometimes feels like a song and dance you can't hear, like holding back in frustration all the love and celebration you would like to savor. It is not the loneliness of not being with anyone, it is the loneliness of not being as and with whom you would like to be. It is the loneliness of the color cast by the shadows of the immense illusions that the soul sketches with its playful innocence. When I fall prey to lethargy, my body paralysis and my mind wanders in a cage and I fight to breathe that is far away, intangible miles from me. I travel in a time that does not exist and that is not the no time of a fool now but rather the drowning of a white wolf zigzagging in a grey basement. Boredom was always the engine of my life, it drove me not to waste my will to live and enjoy. And my vital energy in the stagnation of fear always pressured me to a state of despair until I had no choice but to learn to navigate a state of waiting, a waiting for I don't know what that I am familiar with and that the same time is a surprise that this nameless sea is owing so many glances carries. And when I didn't know how to wait I went out to search and sometimes I found, sometimes I calmed down and sometimes I was destroyed as I wandered through cities that became deserts of coldness. I invoke the desire for pleasure and happiness that resides in you until you cannot distinguish one from the other, until you feel happiness like that bubbling pleasure overflowing in the cells of the infinite universe that you are. I invite you to listen to it and let us all turn this world into the pleasant bacchanal of consent and permission that comes from daring to make our lives the glorious and supreme manifestation of artistic, spiritual, corporal and amorous hedonism. All fused in the encounter that arises when after spying those lovers through the window with restless envy, suddenly you turn and see your friends, your lovers and, who knows, the love of your life could enter through your front door in this moment. And turn on the sound system of those who have not forgotten that they are alive and that the torrents of their blood are the joy of an inextinguishable and refreshing volcano of love, a living and eternal synonym of ecstasy. Where are you? You love me without knowing me. I wait for you without knowing you and I know you in the waiting, and sometimes I don't know myself when, exhausted, I can no longer squash that desire to keep running towards you without knowing where you are and with no other compass than my desire. Without having found you, I feel I lose you and without finding you, I look for you and I feel that you flee from me except in elusive glances that arise in the inhospitable and mysterious dimensions of life that pass like trains that do not stop at the station of encounter. I feel that you see me without recognizing me and I feel that I dream of you without sleeping. Without you rejecting me, pathos visits me and from afar its expletives reach me and touch me, even though we try to let them pass. Without calling me you impel me to cry out to you, with the hope of your existence beats in me the certainty that I will never retire from this joy that is the focus of the light that guides me in the darkness of the swampy marshes of anxiety. If I listen, from afar you sound although you are silent and from my mouth come the songs that accompany me on the journey, while I give voice to the heartbeat of your beauty that I launch to the sky and dedicate to you so that there carries them to you as a messenger of the drum of the guitar of my lungs, steep amplifiers with which I expand the vibration that become joyful in me in order for them to reach you even if they are the sweet echoes of my longings, fresh homeland of my afternoons. Without you caressing me, the hope of you covers the cold that breaks me inside. I see your absence in my lost gaze and I meet you in the depths of it where no one can prevent this unique intimacy that my heart sings with you and that is savor when the winds of the perfumes of your existence become the breeze that caresses my life in the sunsets of the beaches of love in which I leave you in me. The essential motivation. Sometimes I feel like I made the wrong choice, sometimes I feel like I self-sabotage and that's when it's most tempting to beat myself up. A simple choice to go to one place instead of another and once you get to that place you realize that you would like to be in the other place. Then the thousand and one ways of trying to fix it arise. What anguish arises when we feel that we have made a mistake in life, guilt assaults like a bombardment and trust in the present wavers. Old beliefs emerge with force that there are patterns of self-exclusion and self-sabotage that repeat themselves, that seem not to be cured, loneliness intensifies and everything dries up. Only noise and the sense of being stifled all remain and they universe is no longer a symphony but a humming out of tumba a supposedly failed orchestra conductor that is you, the only thing left to do is suffer. That macabre psychotherapist within us with whom we try to fix ourselves is preying on us and anxiety becomes our exasperated movement, swearing to ourselves that from now on we will avoid going against the will of our heart instead of going in favor of that supposed false will that deceived us and that also seemed to come from our heart. We feel that we have betrayed ourselves because we suddenly find ourselves in a moment that is outside the idyllic script that we draw with our mind and that is woven with distrust in the mystery that invades us. Irate and observe that it doit to extract the honey from this veil that it can only embrace, what drain is. What grieving for what we imagine we could have lived, what an absurd pain, what a noise so that we don't feel the rhythmic cracking of love. Sometimes it appears because you didn't ask for the phone number of the girl you met, sometimes because you chose to go somewhere alone or to play basketball and change the date with a girl you think you're starting to like. And how tempting it is to say it's because you exclude yourself because you're afraid of love or to punish yourself and how tempting it is to insult yourself that you were a fool for falling into the traps of a supposedly perverse unconscious that is against you. You look for a thousand consolations and tell yourself that everything obeys a greater purpose that guides you towards triumph, but what I can tell you is that you only found some peace when you comprehended that everything is there to open us in a radical and merciful love. You can judge yourself by saying that you justify yourself, that you deceive yourself, that you don't want to go deeper into what fucks your life up and stay on the surface, but sometimes you can only embrace the insipidity of the prosaic, surrender to the incomprehensible, however grotesque and tasteless what happens to you may seem. The essential self-deception is to believe that at some point you stop being worthy of letting yourself be loved, to justify that you verily screwed up now and you must turn off the tap in the centre of your heart until everything goes back on track to how you imagined. Evolution is not having more and more money, it is not having the perfect partner and all those criteria marked by the evolutionometer. Evolution is the expansion of love that floods you even when you feel devolved or stagnant. The essential motivation is to feel more and more capable of receiving everything with love and that's what most fires you up in life because all other motivations for life projects can collapse at any moment and what will you hold on to? What will be the hook that gets you out of bed in the mornings when the desolate landscape of your deflated ambitions is painted before your eyes? Don't give up on your ambitions but don't forget your primordial ambition. It is the only one that remains in that which we call time. It is the one that roots you in your eternal essential innocence and the one that sweetly apparates so that your experience strangely becomes an infatuation that don't need justification for what happens even if you don't understand it and that arises from your inextinguishable desire to love. What if self-sabotage was not the lack of mental skill to avoid what you were supposed to have avoided but rather the internal self-attack that happens when we don't get things to work out according to our expectations? Once heard that consciousness arrives before something happens in order to prevent it and love arrives after it happens in order to give you tenderness and you also heard that consciousness is only useful until the moment you discover that you are love. The latter resonates with me more because the former implies living in tension, in alertness, in anticipation, in attention to the facts rather than in rapt attention to the light that illuminates our unknowable destiny with love. That destiny that we always try to change when we feel it leads us to tragedy and not to glory, in truth you don't know, you only wish to live in the beauty that arises when love envelopes everything that you pass through with its divine gaze of a goddess. In this way you unite with what is happening without interpreting it and my destiny is fulfilled in the bliss of present love that embraces everything and I feel like sharing myself with the whole universe and that the whole universe share itself in me and destiny stops being the tiring wait for a sinister yagi to give me a good grade and tell me that I did everything right while it's prostrate on my bed at the end of my days, of my hours. There comes a moment when you simply get fed up with questioning the perfection of what is happening because you comprehend that what is perfect is not outside but rather that perfection is looking from what is perfect, from the love that is the infinitely perfect, the infinitely real that frees us from the shaking of the false so that we can rest in the crystalline waters of forgiveness, forgive, the alchemical gift of our journey that melts us into the totality. Open a yet sleep walking. Sometimes you go to far away places used to write, I don't even know if I'm going to do it, I don't even know where I'm going or who I'm with because most of the time I don't find anything but the illusive faces of strangers with whom to dance the inert dance of indifference and empty words together. Sometimes I even take the metro to go to places where I was once happy and where I often only find furtive notes of emptiness and I feel as if I'm sailing in a boat tied to a dock. I don't really sometimes spend my time searching because I have always refused to condemn the search. So many people talk about finding, sometimes I found without looking but I spent most of the time hoping to find while searching. They are strange days, anyone contemplating my route could regard me as a lethargic bee that has lost its way in the hive, but nevertheless when I suddenly stop and drink that sweet sadness which is close to self-compassion, I taste a honey that is here as best I can, moving away from clichés and without taking psychotropics, to go to the traffic of that lyrical and tropical bohemia that I breathe whilst sitting on the bridges that cross the lacustrine nights of the purple beaches of my heart. What pity I feel when the hours become for a play that don't lead to highs, when life becomes an introduction, when I explore the watery and varied colors of loneliness and miss that joyful smile that is its cause in itself that I love to see when I fall in love. Why this the narrowness of the longing that vibrates in the one who pursues the ecstasy of love, bitter like watching a beautiful evening out from the slits of a porch on a cool summer night. And yet an ocean of silence washes over me as I write the music that exhales these words, and the noise becomes nothing but tunlis, orphan waves that we expel like a frustrated cowboy in the Wild West. Perplexed by beauty in such an unknown landscape, more tender with everything each time, I embrace every alarm and delight in compassion and although sometimes curled up in my bed I feel cold tickles of tingling black bells of death, ever greater is the warmth that floods me when I unite myself with a kind of surrender that arises when I stop inflating the pretensions that arise in me when I fight with myself in order not to resign myself, to not make the most life and fly in pleasure. That, for me, is the magic of sunset, which is why I named my blog and my first book after it. Because for me, sunset has a truth like feeling, a truth that perpetuates in eternal peace and dissolves time. Sunset is when I look at life and I fall in love with myself looking at it and I fall in love with myself loving it. Sunset is when the brightness of my eyes spreads to everything oceanically and I dilute and bathe in the delicious air of reunion with effervescent life. Sunset is to dream of real love in your eyes and to dance uncontrollably to the inexplicable joy of mysticism. Sunset is when there is no more late arrival, and my experience becomes the serene bliss of a flowery balcony that merges with the gaze of a beautiful landscape, illuminated with torches of beauty as the radiance of our divinity unfolds in creation. And so I travel from anger to gratitude. Thank you to you who read me, to you who I feel in my smile, to you, that we breathe together the vertigo of this adventure and the calm that is given to us when we discover that this delicious dreaming awakens us from every nightmare and every preparation for the party becomes the celebration itself. A complete journey no way back. When you reject your past, you reject your present and your future, when you reject the future you think you will live, you reject your present experience and your past. When you reject your present you reject your past and your future, because everything is linked. By rejecting your past, your present or your future you reject your whole life experience. Because life is not given to you moment by moment, life is given to you whole and when you open yourself to receive this moment you receive it in its completeness, and completeness is what you experience, we pass through the life that is given to us, to merge with the will of God which is not to resign yourself to the interpretation that we give to the facts, that your will be one with the divine, will is to be willing to love everything without drawing conclusions, it is to offer yourself. Like the Father Mother of the universe to receive everything with love. That is why I like to use the word embrace, because to embrace is non-dichotomous, it is total permission for our rejections to coexist with our will to be in harmony with the script of scripts with which the universe offers itself, it is not in vain, the etymology of the word perfect is per, total, and facto, from factum, done, that is to say that which is totally done. Perfect is not that you demand and force yourself to feel an enlightened harmony of a supposed dichotomous acceptance that is fighting against rejection to completely invade our heart, but precisely to give a place to everything in our infinite internal space where we imbue everything with softness and tenderness, disidentifying ourselves from what happens to our persona, experiencing it as another servant of the great work, embrace allows this identification, the internal self-attack towards. The outsider towards the inside bags as down in the identification of our struggle, that is presence, that is the present and not a supposed temporal space between past and future but, precisely, the present is the gift, as the other meaning of the word present indicates and the gift is none other than to receive everything that happens in time from the no time of the ocean of our essence, it is to have humility in light of life orchestrating everything for our constant creative and expansive re-encounter with the love that we are. It knows what is better for us than that obfuscated stubbornness in which we sometimes get stuck. Total surrender is the offering that attunes us to the whole. Trust is omnidirectional towards these opposed times and gives us fluency. The verb conjugation if there were is the most false conjugation that exists, it is a way of torturing ourselves, the non-questioning of what happens is not as actless so that you don't do everything you want to do in pursuit of your dreams, but it is the contemporary awareness of being in harmony with the fact that free will don't exist and that the same time we dream that it does. Only is free who loves even when they feel they cannot love, our capacity to love embraces our sense of inability and everything is transformed, the future does not change, it is the one that was laid out for us, but yet we feel that we are changing our future, this is the paradox, the mystery that a programmed mind cannot comprehend but in which the heart rejoices in remembering our eternal invulnerability which is anything but indifference and abandonment, and rather infinite love in which we recognize and glorify ourselves in grace. Shipwreck in Barcelona. I woke up in the middle of the night and my boat was alone and wandering in the middle of a dark ocean of incomprehension, only the gypsy praises of my spiritual youth guided me back to my joyful feeling. In me were, repentance, slopes of guilt and cliffs of vengeance. No pleasurable sex, no love, no loneliness of the good kind, use an emptiness that rang mournfully like the church bells of an orphaned village. Victim of myself, who else if not? My pointing fingers shrank in the face of such magnitude of responsibility and yet I felt so capricious, so immature, so stubborn in my weakness. My mouth tasted metallic like a hospital and my body in which I was melting wanted tenderness and to embrace you woman, but I only found indifference, the indifference of the I without the fullness of the I. Geneva was no longer a bipandric city, it was a pink battle that sounded like destiny and the prison was the song of a yay whose eyes sparkled with self-conscious desire. Ah! If only I had that air of the Sierra Morena. I'd breed the sea and thousands of curros Jimenez and students would run through my veins. But there was only you in front of me, grey wall, and sounds of rejection in the room. My life had become ridiculous and I was a clown without trying, but Gloris talked and resisted me and I remembered and this yawn in the corners of your reasonless non-reason and compassion in self-compassion racked me and on the ping-pong tables in the park of the pines Antonia told me that Satan was the sound that sounded when she was singing and her daughter, told me. Dignity, mystical word, but you see, it is nothing other than surrender and that you stop collecting reasons to be able to love me, to stop repudiating me. Solitude is to say goodbye to writing, it is to find oneself without poems, in spiritual bankruptcy, in the company of death, in the endless sepulchral silence, but nevertheless, when songs come to me, from inside me, the songs of the songs, I prostrate myself with smiles and life becomes dessert of you, my friend, my brother, gypsy, gypsy, spice clove of my sweet lung. Source of life. Advance bravely, do not stop when the dark mists of the journey bewitch you, the forests of fear are only mirages, although sometimes the danger really lurks, be cautious, but do not be paralyzed, if you stop, let it be in order to breathe, to regenerate, to contemplate, even to visualize. Life is wild, yes, but you will find companions who encourage you, who breathe songs of glory and salvation into you. And when you least expect it, you will unexpectedly breathe freedom, sometimes even in the middle of the bankruptcy of your soul. There will be moments of panic and despair but you will get back on your feet. There will be beds to lie on and gazes and hugs to rest in. And the muses will shower you with grace and your smile will be flooded with gratitude. And you will never again fall into hell, for you will say your peace for nothing, not for an old joy, for it will be true peace, oceanic happiness, and not a dull truce of the daughter of frustration, for you will be a child of the new and the new will be your eternal dawn, blessed brother, blessed sister. My bliss, my destiny, Maya Pride Companions in the Battles of Existence, Our Silence Will La Fin the Victory of Those of Us Who Knew How to Remain Undaunted in the Face of the Misfortune That Befell Us or That We Sought Out Ourselves. When failure lashes you with malicious mockery and you sparse incapacitating phrases in your ear, remember your strength, get out of there, run, fly, call, beg, laugh, walk, live. We're doing it together. When SHE goes out. When SHE enters. I dream of them, I dream of her, and sometimes in reality she dances with me and her eyes light up in flames and she sways with joy, but suddenly the barren moment arrives. The joy is mute and I feel like a statue without glory, a supporting actor without a script and a flower without a scent. How you wish you would call me and that this frustration of black fire boldn't burn my chest, how you wish your eyes boldn't see dark clown or gypsy and that you would talk about me to your friends. I like it when I sing and dance for you and sometimes I hate myself when you are silent because I disappear, how you would like to live intoxicated with poetry and so that torrents of sweet blood run through my veins, to vanish the nostalgia of alcohol completely and to live praising the glory of living. Sometimes I feel the edge of the future calling me, I don't know if it's the desire that impels me from within or my soul that trembles asking the heavens for you. Sometimes I feel your gaze caressing my heart, so many times I doubted if it was true or a lie, if it was ephemeral brightness or a game, but I always fell because I didn't care if it was true or a lie if for you a second I could feel us together. How many times is the garden? Bursting into my empty flat that screamed pain, how many times he went crazy with the need for affection, how many times he felt kingly and then everything was ruined like when birthday party balloons are punctured and suddenly you feel like an outsider in the cold land of indifference that feels like a gloomy atmosphere of tacit rejection, of regret, a slope of grey rock. But here he stands soberly, full of prayer and strength. And I know, that you will arrive. Like spring arrives with its winds of jasmine and orange blossom. Like songs arrive without permission, like when they greet me and when you surprise me by coming around the corner and the street becomes a tablao and there tastes of bulería and tango. Because I dream you exist, because I dream I am not crazy, because I am crazy I dream, because I dream I rave and because I rave my life varies and because it is life, real life. Death will not defeat it because death is the resignation of the sad person and the sadness vanishes when you take off in flight in pursuit of your dreams. You already have no. No already as you. Yes is getting closer to you. Walking down the street, in the underground, sometimes, in a park, one look, and you connect with someone, but you don't talk to them, and something in you feels like you missed the opportunity. You feel that unsatisfactory sensation of almost, and to live in the almost is to live half-heartedly, all of not celebrated, a frustration, because your heart opens and exhales a bitch of passion that becomes bitter guilt and perfection with all its magnitude does not suffice to satisfy the cancellation of what, who knows if this that is a is madness or pretension of personal power, or of what, could have been and was not. At night I can't sleep, my longing for celebration, for all that I long to live, I rest, yes. But I wake up attentive to take the risk, to temporarily abandon routines without falling into the precipice of distraction, with prudence but without inhibition. Yes, I like to be the protagonist, yes, I like that you go crazy for me, yes, I like it when you desire me and you dare to express your desire, that you take the risk of violating yourself, of becoming dependent. That stranger, suddenly, knows you from the eons of time. You have you seen yourself in the sparkle of her eyes and for a moment you have been lovers in secret, the universe knows it, your soul dances it, but shame and shame is obscure the manifestation of a new world, a world of love that effervescently bubbles up from inside you. It's up to you and me, it's up to you and her, to you and him, we are love and we will become love, from love we come and to love we go, why can't the Indians stop above? Unfortunately we are so stubborn that we are able to bind our unbridled desire to obey an insipid what will they say, until death. But dryness is not your homeland, you want to dare that fear dies in every encounter and that life leads the ebbs and that you live life and that love explodes and floods everything with its magic, that is the apotheosis of creation, whoever tried it knows it. Bravery. Don't let fear rule your life from the shadows, set out boldly towards the horizon you long for. even if you don't see it and clearly or know with any more certainty than the pumping of your enthusiastic heart where it takes you. Don't let shame point your head toward poor ground and stop you and allow hypothetical scenarios of supposed debacles, failures and don't let those what will they say those others who speak inside and outside of you make the smoothness of a firm decision blase in pursuit of your sweet dreams. Lift your gaze with dignity in front of everyone with that inextinguishable innocence that no guilt can restrain. There is a coldness that paralyzes us without realizing it, a dry comfort in the uncomfortable false security that freezes us and stands our movements, the fear that excludes us in a paralyzing loneliness that vomits us into barren moments of quiet and strangely restful despair. There is not much precision in the imprecise, but there is a soulful sound that guides us, the echo of a blissful and remote pleasure in a future that is alive in the present. Sometimes we tremble when what we desire approaches, we stir like growling dogs in the waste grounds of the nights that catch us unawares and unprepared, waiting, always waiting, sometimes without knowing for what, walking and sometimes limping towards that festive and glorious music of celebration that calls us enchantingly from afar. Ye stand on street corners to write, to gather strength for tiger slips into oceanic and exciting feelings that fuse me with the joy of life, the ready and feel terribly lonely before I feel completely accompanied by the whole of existence. It is not the cold of the street, it is the cold of your body's marrow that asks for the living flame of the soul and the fresh sparkle of the gaze of graceful love dancing. The stubborn no presents itself as a fraudulent guardian of the gates of paradise that the key of yes opens. Woe is me when the sea runs through me like ayahuasca that awakens the most hidden desires, there is no blanket that covers such a shadow that leaves a trace of sadness when it is ignored. Yes, you may feel vulnerable as you pounce with praise from the mobile beacon of your heart, but, it's worth the adventure, such a magnitude of wildlife bursting forth. A kiss that does not kill you a little is a cowardly kiss, to leave being decided by flow is vartillanas, moreover temperance is not an enemy either, but rather a cautious radar to avoid falling into the precipices of ruin. You hurried me and comprehend me without needing to understand me, for a split second you feel the poison that vaccinates me in the eternal, beyond perdition, that shelters a sin a recalcitrant fragility that only leaves that silent and insipid clamor in your mouth, that invites you again and again to enjoy the life you want to live running through the celestial highways of your veins. Mermaid siren souls. There is not much precision in the imprecise but there is a sound that guides us, the echo of a remote pleasure in a future that is alive in the present. I curse my likings that sometimes lead me down the road to perdition even though they sometimes fill me with a momentary blessing. I always liked something about triple or double lives, although we don't know if it has more to do with dissociation and fear than with the lack of integrity of the force of the flood of coherence. Coherence infuriates because the world is full of hypocrisy, a hypocrisy that it owes to manipulate and achieve the ends it desires. Paradise as much of the forbidden pleasures of hell, uncoincidentally because in Islamic heaven men enjoy 70 perpetual virgins. Life corners you, it says to you, I am sorry, I am not going to let you fool yourself anymore, I am going to take you straight to what you like the most. It challenges you to see how much more you can endure in a false heaven of dissatisfaction. Until you get fed up and dare to transgress the limits that only you impose. With fear you will go towards what you desire, with the same desire to arrive as to escape, with the same desire to enjoy as to escape. If you don't give in to your desires you become psychotized, you become mad, and violence, mockery, indignity, disrespect surround you. Until you dare with shame is but determination to enter this kinky place. You can't build a life on lies, your being will crumble and fall, you don't need drugs to numb your defenses. You become bored because you refuse to support yourself in fulfilling your most hidden desires. It's not life that bores you, it's your creation. Loneliness invades you because you leave yourself alone. There comes a time when you become psychotized. And if you give desires free rein, you also go crazy from the explosion of what was repressed and contained, but that explosion fills you with the inner strength that repression takes away from you and which weakens you. Don't let confusion paralyze you, throw yourself into it. You flee from ayahuasca like one flees from the truth. The truth only unsettles you and keeps you tense until you come to terms with it, but when you savor its scent, it calms you down. It is not enough to say I was myself once I got it, life takes you again and again on the path of undressing, to the infinite expansion of your being. This is the chronicle of an exhibitionist of the soul and the body. You will encounter hostility but also admiration, if you allow yourself to be, to let yourself be, there will be nothing and nobody that can stop you, except when you want to stop and breathe. If the place where you stop inspires you, it is because that place is in harmony with your being. Moreira. The edge of death beats in life and challenges our fearlessness to cross deseas of intensity. It is the cold that makes us seek the warmth of love and when fear raises its mournful song of icy pain, the desire to enjoy the continuous moment of our journey is announced on our skin. Every rigid time table vanishes when the fury of our heart cries out for joy, every sadness becomes a barda and a singing menade that incites us to go beyond the limits in which we shroud ourselves, with numbing caution, which as the mauve color of lacking oxygen and we drown in the insipidity of the anodyne. When we stiffen in grey rooms that smell of the fagani, thousands of auditory channels open in our soul that listen, however distant they may be, to the moans of pleasure and the cheers of happiness that we wish to convulse us in the silence, and the last fall glances of those who was appear, and who vanished in a dense and mocking mist of I don't know what. And what we believe could have been and wasn't becomes a crazy goal that drives the compasses of our path crazy, while we twist ourselves in pursuit that our life become an ecstatic and poetic celebration. Music continues to play and stirs us to awaken and free ourselves from the funereal, arachnid and paralytic chair on which we are sat, and we stumble into the sharp corners of that cell, where the master keys we carry in our enthusiasm seem to rust, that magic spark we carry inside us that, when lit, opens the doors of divine experience. We go out into the street, there is nothing, and yet everything is in some sweet somewhere that we seek, in some here and now that is not here and now, where we find again the precious symphony of plenitude and drink from the cup of the sabrina ambrosia of total satisfaction with which we fill we reign without reigning extensively, to feel, if only for a second, the vibrant, placid and eternal expansion of our being. The patio of my poems. Sometimes I had the feeling that I gave you my love with something like misspellings, clumsy poses in the softness with which I wanted to treat you, misspellings that only disappeared in the compassionate gaze of those who madly love each other. But it was nothing more than the dyslexia of a stupid judgment that I saw myself with and that distorted the freshness of my innocent enthusiasm. And because of that which they say a kiss is a verse that is written with the lips and read with the eyes closed I gave myself fiercely to you. The verses that dance and relish in the wide patio of my poems escaped from the prisons of fear and pass through the gates towards the green meadows of your dreams, there they are fertilized in the longings of your infinite love and they expand, their vibrations heard in the wild beats of the heart. Boredom. You are the indigestion of my unfulfilled dreams, the nostalgia of when desire and satisfaction were one, fused in God. You are the languish of impotence and frustration, the scary of my days and sleepless nights as I gaze with complicity and longing for the fullness of eternity. You are a grey stream of weeping that waters the infertile fields of my stubborn attempts to reach ecstasy, there where the black flowers grow that I choke on when they come out of my mouth and exhale the repugnant smell with which I suffocate. You are a constant descent moaning inside me with a memory of glory. You are a bitter horror and a bitter complaint that bleeds in my heart and that consumes me from the inside, that only gets drunk on the liquor of love and fun. You are the hate of loneliness, which is not the absence of people but rather not being like and not being with those you would like to be with, because loneliness and dissatisfaction are the same thing. You are the dull dread of the thundering silence of an empty bed disguised as a harmless plea and yet you are the vast plea when life seduces and deludes me. You are my refusal to encounter anything that does not fulfill or attract me. You are life passing through a screen. You are a false poem that repeats itself, the longing to drink in a self-compelled abstinence, you would change everything I write to fulfill everything I desire, you would throw it into the fire if it would light the flame that would be light in this dullness that is a far sometimes that seems like always, in this darkness in which I stagger like a blind man who does not know where he is going. You are a furious fool of rage and honey that lives in me and that I am, when, even though thousands of people could be reading and comprehending me, I feel like a small lung unable to breathe the whole universe. You are a young boy lying on a bed smelling the flatulence of this prose, beautiful stench of tuberose and hawthorn. You are the edge of my restlessness, a heavy regret, As you are poet jugadores de females who fly from him in the dreamlike night. You are the stupid and infantile drama of a lazy person disguising his reluctance as something sublime. You read the demand that explodes and that is out to the disembodied lady of the universe, my human whims fighting against divine whims, you read the fury that don't know what to fight against, what to hit. You are the spit that you swallow when you believe all of this from me, you are a truth of badly written, the doubt of the wise man who knows nothing, you are the envy I have for what you would like to experience, you are a little that hurts a lot, the scarcity of a fountain reluctant to give water, you are the clumsiness of a philanderer who feels inept, an unanswered message, a date dying in the imagination, the reverse angle shot of a gaze that fascinates me but that I don't manage to see. A long prose that becomes short when suddenly pleasure is too short-lived the waiting becomes so long, you are a guilt when you stare at me and I don't know what to say to you, you are everything that is not in me and that strangely lives when it feels like dying for not having been brought to life. You are a boldness that can't be disguised, you are a walk with slouched shoulders, you are the hunchback of a man who limps, the mockery of a femme fatale, the failure of the most beautiful love, you are a existential frigidity with short-lived orgasms, you are the tiredness of the search and everything that don't work, you are the fright and happiness, the seat of a text that don't end well. Chronicle of an alcoholic. I confess, I am an alcoholic, and it is the only identification I should never give up, willingly or unwillingly, for all the success of an alcoholic lies in one thing, in not drinking, in never drinking, in not drinking today. I am an alcoholic or there is an alcoholic living in me and when I drink I give him all the power. You could say I have alcoholism but when you relapse you realize that alcoholism has you in its grip. You could say I suffer from alcoholism, an inability to drink alcohol while being capable of many other things. You could also say that an alcoholic lives in me and takes all the power when I give him a single drop to drink. My life taught me that I will lose everything I want if I drink and that everything I long for comes to me and will come to me if I am able to maintain that lucid awareness as long as a single drink, sibylline poison for me, does not enter my veins. It is exhausting to fall again. To lose peace, self-esteem, confidence, dignity, money, guitars, to lose friends, to feel myself drifting away from everything and everyone and that everything is drifting away from me. It is a chronic, progressive and fatal disease that never rests. One drink is too much and a thousand is not enough. Every alcoholic wishes he could control his drinking, wonders why he can't and others apparently can. Every alcoholic wishes to live in that supposedly illusory that drunkenness bestows without leaving a single trace of distraction in his clumsy walk, but that is as impossible as hiding the stains and smell of vomit stained sheets. It is like trying to walk with a noisy loudspeaker without being seen, at the same time you want everyone to see you, because you think you are the best but only the ruins remain. I have gone back to the alcoholics and anonymous meetings you said to attend with the intention that the group will help me to maintain that fresh awareness because all the frustration of an alcoholic comes when they are not able to hold firm to their disease and not to drink, when they feel they have failed again on the promises they made to themselves when they relapsed, when they feel like the beater bane of a capricious will in the chaos of a moment of euphoria or depression and decide in a fit of false empowerment and deluded confidence to pick up the drink again. If you ask me what alcoholism is, I will tell you that I don't know, for me it is a mystery and maybe it will always be a mystery but I can say a lot about it paradoxically. The only way to manage this disease is to be aware that you will never manage it. Self-deception is always present and vanity may you believe one of the lies that fly through your mind inciting you that nothing will happen and you can once again enter the black battering storm that will demolish everything. Then you can't believe it. You shake your head like when in a catastrophic lucid dream you know you use have to get yourself together to wake up in the warmth of your bed where everything is still safe, but you don't, you stay stuck there while a menacing cloud dazzles everything with its metallic and demonic sound. In Triple A, Alcoholics Anonymous Association, an ancient prayer is recited, known as the Serenity Prayer, which goes back even before the origins of the Foundation. Lord, grant me the serenity to accept what I cannot change, the courage to change what I am able to change and the wisdom to understand the difference. In my pilgrimage through spirituality and psychology I have immersed myself in a more fatty, a trust in everything that happens given to the idea that supreme love guides everything, that is, the idea that self-will does not exist, everything is a mutual choice and life is an experiential cloak that moves in oneness, I have come to be grateful, on numerous occasions as the concatenation of a series of events that I felt as faithful led me to meet people or life experiences that fulfilled me. Deeply inside. But at this point in my life I can't allow myself to consider this idea to be true even if it is. I have to believe that I have some kind of personal power, otherwise everything will become an excuse to let myself be guided, not by love, but by the unconsciousness of some repetitive pattern or program that leads me to the pits of hell again and again. This belief invades me, I feel like a hypocrite pandering here once again believing that this time will be definitive as if I don't know for sure if my will is complete and total when it comes to closing that door once and for all, as if somewhere in me it were still a sacrifice or a renunciation of something I don't want to lose. Maybe it's the good times I had drinking when I felt like a false king of the party, but in reality, and I say this without trying to convince myself, I have already experienced that I can enjoy myself even more without drinking, so why is it that somewhere hidden in me there is still a dormant and latent feeling that I am going to lose something by renouncing the very thing that makes me lose everything? When you drink you let it in but in reality you let it out, uncorking a bottle is uncorking the sewer. Use like Barney in his Simpsons short quoted Shakespeare when he said, once a sensible man, now a madman, now a beast. But in my case, it all started as a madman turning into a beast, and now from the deepest part of myself I want to consolidate myself as a sensible man with a harmonious life. When an alcoholic is active he wants only one thing, to drink. Only by some force majeure does stop. The paths of this disease lead to the roots of the hospital, the asylum, prison, the cemetery. You isolate yourself because drinking gives you a false everything but when the alcoholic pump bursts you see your dirty clothes, your empty pockets, the faces of sorrow and contempt all around you, and you can only do two things, go back to drinking or face hell and seek help. Then fear arises because you are afraid of the consequences of what you did, when you get your phone back you nervously check your bank account to check the record or you are worried that the police will call your doorbell and take you away for having offended someone or having committed some idiocy that you don't remember. There are so many things that one thinks about and the nightmares that come to one's mind that at night you see bar with chills and suffering. Fear also arises because you don't feel capable of ensuring a future in which nothing will ever lead you to drink again. One starts to drink for many reasons, because you want to become uninhibited, to flirt, to alleviate mental problems, all those reasons don't exist in me today, I discovered the surrender of everything to a superior power that takes care of everything but nevertheless I am still, surprisingly falling. It takes many days to build what you dream of and a single moment of carelessness to ruin it. Despair is feeling that your life is unmanageable, that you are powerless over alcohol, and that the same time that recognition is your salvation. Your willpower fails, even your goodwill fails, only an inexplicable miracle can save you from maintaining your determination from now on to your death while you are occupied with only one thing, news for today I want a drink, news for now I want a drink. Don't think for a moment that an alcoholic necessarily lives thinking about drinking, you can feel so sure that you have already achieved it, that you don't need it, that life is much better without drinking, that everything is regenerating and flourishing around you and suddenly one day without knowing why, you fall, it's not victimhood, maybe weakness, maybe pride. I don't know, but if you are not attentive to every second, your life is in danger. An alcoholic is an alcoholic all his life even if he does not drink, for biological reasons, educational reasons, a mixture of them, or a mystery, you can no more drink than a diabetic can take sugar. Healing is not getting it under control as if by healing some unconscious cause or repression the symptom disappears. Healing is coming into harmony with that limitation, it is the awareness of the disease and you will doubt it and try to achieve more freedom by drinking but you will only fall back into slavery. The mind will offer you a thousand causes from which you have to free yourself in order to stop drinking, maybe it will tell you the same old one or a new one each time, whatever it is, if you deal with it, do it without alcohol, because it won't help you, it is not a medicine and if you achieve something with it you will need it even more to free yourself again and again in an insatiable impulse of non-conformity. write without wanting to stop writing, because raising my head means once again to look at the anguishing uncertainty of my life, and believe me, my life is very beautiful, I don't blame life, not even myself, but if I am not attentive and fall asleep, the nightmare will return again and again like a dark fog that extinguishes the light of the happiness of my glory days. What is the relationship between my alcoholism and affective, sexual or pleasure dissatisfaction? Vice is a distortion of the sense of the infinite, is how Baudelaire expressed himself crudely and emphatically in The Flowers of Evil. He invaded the archetype of the flaneur, the stroller of the Parisian night in search of ecstasy, enjoyment, furtive love and liberation from boredom and ennui. A romanticization of the walk through the portico of hell, and use as Joaquin Sabina and Bukowski poeticized and exalted the battle as the muse of their poems and songs, so I also lyricized my alcoholism by endowing it with a reasoning or a ideology that sought to achieve a strange triumph fin the budding of defeatism and self-pity. When I go out at night and get drunk it's like rolling the dice, I never know what's going to happen to me said Jim Morrison, and there were and are many who, like me, have sought in a kind of alchemical bewilderment of the senses to end up having pleasurable orgasmic experiences or meet the partner of a lifetime. I have always felt love for many people, a tenderness and affection that made me want to hug and kiss them. When I started to have sex it was with a lot of anxiety and when I finally started to have experiences there were many frustrations and also many moments of pleasure. I always envied women in their orgasmic capacity and that's why I started looking for ways to experience those penetrating orgasms, so I opened myself to experience different kinky ways in which I could have this experience, but although I have had plenty of enjoyment and sometimes fully, the fullness is an escalation and one always wants more, I be always wanted to convulse with pleasure and that's a trap, because alcohol tells you, until you get it you can't leave me and although now we know that I can experience all that without the instrument of alcohol there is still something that makes me think that it would be easier to throw myself into it and that it would happen that way. But for that there is also MDMA, which can be taken with water and without a single drop of alcohol and, if everything comes together, can facilitate an intimate encounter of total communion in which the incandescence of the sire and the sire itself satisfies and fills you until you feel so full that you share it. A romantic lust that is not a false connection but a true connection that undoes all prudish inhibitions. The people I crossed paths with and what I allowed myself to experience in a way I still could not or would not, I leave up to you to imagine so that you can also connect with the infinite possibilities that haunt me and many others. I always gave myself fully in every experience to treat the people with whom I shared with the greatest possible affection. Because I have always been looking for a wild and lascivious and at the same time loving and tender female to love completely and who loves me. Withdrawal is the compulsion to drink, suddenly all you want to do is open your throat and let rivers of alcohol flow. It's like drowning, it's dreaming really hard about what you want to experience and feeling that your single ticket towards it is a beer. It's hearing music in the background calling you, a faraway party that you're missing, yet you're moving away from the real party of peace and enjoyment that's in your heart. But you don't see that because you've missed it. It is physical, very physical, until a few days go by, when it is very hard to bear but it is easier to see it and therefore if you really hold on you can avoid drinking. However, when you have not been drinking for a while and the physical compulsion has disappeared, another withdrawal appears that is much more subtle and much easier to hide, and because it is less evident, it is easier to catch you unawares and therefore you run the risk of letting yourself be carried away by that first drink. There is no withdrawal without depression and anxiety, it's as if there is a parasite in me that wants to drink and drags me down. In withdrawal you are alone, it is very desperate, you wander around like a panther in a cage, you try to look for something to replace alcohol. It can be tobacco, a non-alcoholic beer or anything else but nothing comes close and if you take the wild decision to drink you can end up on the floor with a broken head. If you are looking for a loving encounter or sex it is as if a vacuum stands between you and the other person that prevents you from touching each other. It seems like it will never end, sometimes it seems like it's gone and then it comes back stronger. All its cells open and close their mouths clamoring for the ethyl liquid and you stand there squirming, not knowing what to do. Sometimes you wish you could disappear, you can only breathe, over and over again. You've hit rock bottom, God love help me, without you I can't do it, Give me strength, Lord. I need you. I can't build anything new without you, for you are the God of the new, Lord, the God of spring, the God of sanity and serenity. Antonio Scotado spoke of the ideal of the bon vivant that invaded and called sober drunkenness, something that for me is not passable with the substance of alcohol, although it is passable with entheogens and perhaps also entactogens. Sobriety is deeper than simply not drinking alcohol, sobriety is a journey of joyful discovery, a journey that intoxicates with poetry, enthusiasm, love, strength and creativity. My sobriety is my treasure. Sergio Sanz Navarro and his song to life. After the publication of my first book, Undressing Myself to Life, Chronicle of a Sunset, where I laid some of the conceptual foundations of my experiential worldview and also some intimate stories. A lyrical torrent arose in me from which to communicate in the way that most delights me. This way is poetic, rich in metaphors and literary figures, without a punctilious or explanatory development but with the distilled essence of what arises in my transmission. More than introducing myself here, I long for you to feel my presence in you through what I write and the presence of that vital joy and that electric cascade of beauty that invades me when I write, I breathe into the words like a fresh wind of novelty, celebration, enthusiasm and love for life.